Good morning students, welcome to the class. This is your CGM theory class. Okay, in the previous class we completed up to color palette. Today I will discuss about a new topic, which is your image file format. Okay, so let us discuss in detail. Image file format. What are the different image files are used in digital images? The formats are, first one is your JPEG. JPEG stands for Joint Photographic Export Group. Okay, it is used for digital images, especially for those images which are composed of digital photography. The extension name of the JPEG file is .jpeg to save the file. A .jpeg is used to save the file with the extension name. Okay. Next one is our PNG. PNG stands for Portable Network Graphics. These files are stored. These files are commonly used to store graphics for web images. PNG was developed to enhance the non-registered replacement of graphics interchange format. Okay, the extension of this file is .png. To save the file, we use the .png extension. Okay. Next one is our GIF. GIF stands for Graphics Interchange Format. Okay, it is a file format for storing graphical images up to 256 colors. PNG is based on a lossless compression method which makes higher quality output. PNG was created as a more powerful option to the GIF file format. Okay, the extension name of this file format is .gif. To save the file, we use .gif extension. Okay, next one is our TIFF or TIF. These files can be saved in a collection of color format and many forms of compression. TIFF file is used to maintain image integrity and clarity. These things is important. This is maintain image integrity and clarity. It is often used for professional photography. The extension name of this file is .tif. To save the file, we use .tif extension. Next one is our PSD. PSD stands for Photoshop document. It is a layered image file used in Adobe Photoshop. It is a default format that is used by Photoshop for saving data. PSD is a custody file that allows the user to work with images separate layer even after the file has been saved. .psd is the file extension to use to save the file. Okay. Next one is our PDF, Portable Document Format. PDF stands for Portable Document Format. Okay. It is used to share the documents between computers and across operating system platform when the user needs to save file that cannot be altered. The extension name for this file is .pdf. .pdf is used to save the file. Okay. Next one is our EPS. EPS stands for Encapsulated Postscript. It is a graphics file format which is used in vector-based images. In Windows, the user needs graphics software to open the EPS file. Okay. For example, Adobe Illustrator, CorelDRAW, etc. The extension name of this file is .eps. .eps is used to save the file. Next one is our AI, means Adobe Illustrator document. Okay, it is a file format developed by Adobe system. It is used to represent single page vector based drawing in EPS or PDF format. The extension name of this file is .ai. AI is used to save the file. Okay, this one is your concept of image file format. Next, we discuss about image evaluation. Image evaluation is the process by which you determine whether each projection is correctly identified and marked, whether it has sufficient diagnostic quality to meet the minimum requirement of the order, or must be repeated. That means when we evaluate an image, we correctly identify the picture quality or sufficient memory space is occupied or not, or what are the requirement of this image. All these things we evaluate in the process of image evaluation. Okay. Next concept is our layers. Layers are used in digital image editing to separate different elements of an image. A layer can be compared to a transparency on which imaging effects or images are applied and placed over or under an image. That means layer is a process where it is used to editing the digital image. Okay. Different types of layers are also there. There are different kinds of layers, and not all of them exist in all program. Okay, they represent a part of a picture either as pixel or as modification instruction. That means different types of layers means different part of a picture. Okay, they are stacked on top of each other and depending on the order determine the appearance of the final picture. That means the image is stack of the different picture, a different stack in a order depending on the appearance of the final picture. Okay, in graphics, layers are different level at which one can place an object or image file. That means in graphics software, layers are different level. Okay, in the program, layer can be stacked, merged or defined when creating a digital image. Okay, layers can be partially obscured, allowing portions of image within a layer to be hidden or shown in translucent manner within another image. That means layer means the pictures are stacked one by one, and after that the output can be look like a realistic image. Okay, layers can be used to combine two or more images into a single digital image for the purpose of editing. Working with layers allows for applying changes to adjust one specific layer. Okay, so next we discuss about the types of layer. First layer is your layer basic. Okay, the standard kind of layer is called simply layer. Okay, it contains just a picture which can be superimposed on another one. That means it contains a picture which is over another picture, but it will not cover that picture. Okay, the picture can cover the same area as the resulting picture, just a part of it, or in some cases a bigger part than the final picture. Okay. So in this example, here top layer is the bird, where it is moved to the left, and in this picture top layer is moved to the right. Top layer is also, see, in this, in two pictures some little bit difference are there. In this picture the birds are here, and in this picture the birds are here. That means here two layers are there, one is your bird and another one is this scenery. Okay, I'll discuss in detail. A layer can have certain transparency or opacity and a number of other properties. A high-end program like Adobe Photoshop, a basic layer may have more than 100 different possible settings. Okay. Even though some of them overlap and given the same result, they give a skilled user a lot of flexibility. A free program like GIMP may not have as many settings, but well used they can often provide a satisfactory result. Okay. Two layers can be blended using one several mode, which result in different light and color combination. Okay. Here in this picture, the top layer is the bird. It's partially transparent, so the background clearly can be seen through its wing. Isn't it? That means this is wing, the bird's wing, but the background trees are also shown here according to the transparency. But in this picture, top layer is drop shadow, a red color overlap 40%. Isn't it this one? A gradient overlay from red or to yellow 20% opacity. This one, red to yellow, okay, and a slight bilevel effect. That means here in this portion the trees are not shown here because these wings are not transparent, but here the wings are transparent, so in this way the trees are shown here. Okay, but in this portion the trees are not shown here, and in between this area, so this portion will be remove this trees are removed this, but it is when first layer is this bird, second layer is this shadow, third layer is this one. Okay, when you draw a picture, first you draw a scenery, then you draw a bird, and in between this portion you remove this trees. Okay, that means when you draw an image, different layer, when we draw an image, different pictures are there, then we stack these pictures in an order. At the result, the image is look realistic. Okay, effect. Okay, this one is your basic layer. Next is your layer mask. A layer mask is linked to a layer and hides a part of the layer from the picture. What is painted black on the layer mask will not be visible in the final picture. Okay. What is gray will be more or less transparent depending on the shade of the gray. Okay. Here, if we dark this more darkening, then this portion is not shown here, this treasure, but here we will little bit gray color, so for this portion is this treasure shown here. Okay, as the layer mask can be both edited and moved around independently of both the background layer and the layer it applies to, it gives the user the ability to taste a lot of different combination of overlay. Okay, that means here this picture consists a blue background on the top of the layer and confires caught using a layer mask in the shape of seagull. Okay, that means in this picture here three layers are there. How it is possible? First layer is your background layer, which is your blue sky. Then you use the greenery use as top layer over this blue layer. Okay, this one is background, then the top layer is greenery or the trees are there. Then the layer mask was applied to the top layer and the white space is a mask over to black. That means then the birds are shown at the top of the layer so that this portion is look like, and that means the trees are not shown and the birds are shown. If we not shown this bird, then the this portion, that means when we remove this birds from this trees or greenery portion, then the birds portion is top portion is look like this. Okay, so this one is your layer mask, concept of layer mask. Next we discuss about the adjacent layer. An adjacent layer typically applies a common effect like brightness or saturation to the other layer. That means here we adjust some brightness or saturation, or in other words we can also say that brightness or darkness. However, as the effect is stored in a separate layer, it is easy to try it out and switch between different alternatives without changing the original layer. Okay. In addition, an adjustment layer can easily be edited just like a layer mask. So, on an effect can be applied a just part of the image. That means here, first layer is our the blue sky, then the greenery part, the portion which we want to greenery, that portion we will show here. Okay, then the greenery, next layer is your greenery. After that, here we color this all this portion and darkness or brightness. Okay, then that portion only this means here is this one is your top layer which the birds color are there. Okay, and the next top layers back layer is your this one and the greenery portion, then greenery portion's background layer is your blue sky portion. Okay, a gradient applied as an adjustment layer to the entire image except for the oval in the middle which was cut out from the adjustment layer. That means in the adjustment layer only this portion we only cut out and adjust the color. Okay, or any changes we can make in on that portion. So in this class this much. In the next class we will discuss another thing. Thank you.